Hi everyone, welcome to Ghanitalai. This is Meerawali. In this video, I am going to discuss the circles. Already I have done more videos about the circles. In this video, I am going to discuss about the position of a point with respect to the circle. Next one, power of a point with respect to the circle. Okay, let's start the topic. Okay, before going to this concept, let me complete one remaining problem on the before video. Okay, look at here. The given problem is, what is the given problem here? If the abscissa of two points A and B are two roots of the equation x square plus 2ax minus b square is equal to 0, and their ordinates are the roots of the equations, so and so, then find the equation of the circle for which AB is a diameter. Okay, look at here. Given in the problem, the two points are there. What are the two points here? Capital A and capital B. First, we have taken their coordinates are, let capital A x1, y1, capital B is x2, y2. Okay, they are the given two points we have taken here. So, in the given problem, the abscissa, what is the meaning of abscissa of the two points? And here one more is used here. And their ordinates are, what is the meanings of abscissa and ordinates? So, observe that, suppose P x1, y1 be a point. So, the point consisting of two coordinates here. So, here the first one is, that is the x coordinate. We know that about that one. This is the y coordinate. Okay, so simply they can also taken as, the x coordinate can also taken as abscissa. Okay, what we say that abscissa. Okay, next y coordinate can simply taken as ordinates. Okay, they are the notations for the points, the coordinates of the points. Okay, so in the same process, what are the meanings of abscissa and ordinates of the given points? So the abscissa are the first coordinates of the given two points. So therefore, here abscissa of the two points AB, so here abscissa means the x coordinates, they are the abscissa of the coordinates of the points A and B, are the roots of the given equation, this one. Okay, so first we have to take in here. So here given equations are, so first we can consider x square plus 2ax minus b square is equal to 0. Let it be equation 1. Next, one more equation is there, y square plus 2py minus q square is equal to 0. This is equation number 2. Observe here the given equations 1 and 2. So the first equation, what is the variable you have? So what is the degree of this equation? This is the second degree equation in the variable x. Already we know that in the lower sections. So if the degree of the equation is 2 in one variable, that is called the quadratic equation. So here what is the variable in the equation 1? So the variable is the x. So this is the second degree equation, which is called the quadratic equation in the x. We know that the roots of the equations are alpha comma beta. So in before lower section, we have to consider the roots of the quadratic equation as alpha comma beta. So where alpha comma beta are the nothing but the values of x. So that means the roots means they satisfy the given equation. Here alpha satisfies the given equation 1 and beta satisfies the given equation 1. So that means if you take in the quadratic equation general form, ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0. This is the quadratic equation. It consisting of two roots, say alpha comma beta. So where alpha comma beta are the roots of the equation, above equation, that means where alpha is the value of x and beta is also a value of x. Okay, so here we know that the sum of the roots alpha plus beta is equal to minus x coefficient. What is the x coefficient here? D by x square coefficient. What is that? A. This is the formula. Second one, product of the roots alpha into beta is equal to constant. What is the constant here? C by x square coefficient. What is that? A. So they are the formulas. If the roots of the quadratic equation you have known, so then next what we have to written? Alpha plus beta, that means sum of the roots and product of the roots are the formulas of this one. Okay, so let's come to the problem, our problem here. So you have to use here two formulas, sum of the roots and product of the roots of a quadratic equation. So now in the given problem here, equation 1 is there. So for the equation 1 here, given that abscissa of the two points A and B are the roots of this equation 1. That means here what are the abscissa of the two points? So therefore given that we have taken, given that abscissa of A comma B are the roots of 1. That means what are the abscissas? That implies abscissa of A comma B means the x coordinates of A and B. What are the x coordinates? X1 comma X2 are the roots of equation 1. So here the roots can be taken as X1 and X2. We learned about the 10th class method, the roots of the quadratic equation can be taken as alpha comma beta. Here we can consider x1 comma x2. So in the same process, sum of the roots is equal to, the formula is, so the equation 1 having the variable x, so that means x coefficient minus x coefficient. What is the x coefficient here? Minus 2a by x square coefficient. What is that? 1. So that is equal to minus 2a. In the same process, the product of the roots x1 into x2 is equal to constant term. What is the constant term you have? Minus b square. So minus b square by x coefficient. What is x square coefficient? What is the x square coefficient? 1, which is equal to minus b square. So therefore we have x1 plus x2 is equal to minus 2a, and x1 into x2 is equal to what is that? Minus b square. So let's take the pair is equation number 3. Okay, in the same process here, this is about the first equation 1. Okay, next thing here, given that their ordinate means, so here the ordinates of A point and B point are the roots of this equation. This can be taken in second equation. In the same process we have to take here, given that the ordinates of A and B are the roots of equation 2. Okay, here equation 2, okay, I have taken here, I'm going to copy this equation here. This is the second equation. And write here equation 2. What is that here equation? This is the equation 2. Okay, so the roots of equation, this one. Okay, that means here ordinates of A comma B, ordinates of the point A and B means, ordinate means the y coordinates of the point A and point B. What are the y coordinates here? Y1 and y2, they are the ordinates of A and B. So in the problem, therefore ordinates of A and B means y1 and y2 are the roots of equation 2. Equation 2 means this is the equation 2. Okay, so in the same process, this is also the quadratic equation in y, so that's why we have to write the sum of the roots. Here roots are y1, y2, so sum means we have to add them. The sum of the roots is minus y coefficient. What is the y coefficient here? 2p by y square coefficient, what is the y square coefficient? 1, that is equal to minus 2p. The same process, product of the roots. So that means we can product the roots y1 and y2. y1 y2 is equal to constant. What is the constant in the equation 2? Minus q square by y square coefficient. What is that? 1. That is minus q square. So here we get here. So y1 plus y2 is equal to minus 2p. And y1 into y2 is equal to minus q square. So let us consider the pair of equation is equation number 4. Okay. So this is our given problem and also given that abscissa are the roots of the equation 1 and ordinates of the equation 2. Then we can get here equation 3 and equation 4. Then what we have to find here? Then find the equation of the circle for which AB as the diameter. Already a formula will be there when the ends of diameter will be given, the equation of the circle is here. Therefore, finally, we have to find the equation of a circle having AB as the diameter. AB as a diameter. So what is the formula I have told you? So which is x minus x1 into x minus x2 plus y minus y1 into y minus y2 is equal to 0. This is the problem. Okay. Here A point is x1 y1, B point is x2 y2. So there is no substitution for the points here A and B. So directly we can product them. So now x square minus x2x minus x1x plus x1x2 plus y square minus yy2 minus y1y plus y1y2 is equal to 0. So how can you arrange the equation of a circle? First you have to write x square term, next y square term. Next, you should write the x term. What are the x term observed here? So here x is there, here x is there, and making minus x common in this one, how much you will get? X1 plus x2 into x. Next, in the same process, you have to write the y terms. Here y, okay? So making y common, minus y common, you will get y1 plus y2 into y. Next, the constant term. So remaining terms will be constant. What are the constants here? X1 x2 plus y1 y2 is equal to 0. Okay, already we have from the equation 3, x1 plus x2 is equal to how much? Minus 2a. From the equation 4, what is that? Y1 plus y2 is equal to minus 2p. You can put here the equations. Look at here, what are the given equations in the problem? Plus 2py. So this is the p, sorry, I have written wrong here. This is 2p, sorry, 2ax, sorry. So given equation is correct, so 2a. So now you can substitute here x1 plus x2 answer and y1 plus y2 and x1, x2. So now x square plus y square minus x1 plus x2 means what is the x1 plus x2 answer? Minus 2a. So here minus 2a into x minus y1 plus y2 answer will be this one. What is that? Minus 2p. You can write here minus 2p into y plus x1 into x2. From the equation number 3, we have x1 into x2 is equal to minus b square. You can write here minus b square minus b square plus y1 into y2 is equal to minus q square, okay, is equal to 0. Now simplifying this equation, you will get the answer. Okay, so that is the equation of your circle, x square plus y square minus of minus plus 2ax plus 2py minus, you can take the minus common, minus b square minus q square. is equal to 0. This is the equation of the circle, okay, our required circle. Okay, this is the problem. Okay, look at here. This problem will be, if the problem will be given in objective type question, you have to write simply here. Remember this note. Here given that in this problem, two equations, x square. What are the two equations here? X square plus 2ax minus b square. This is a quadratic equation in x. And one more quadratic equation will be given. So this can also taken in terms of x or in terms of y, okay, depending upon the given equation. I have taken the two equations. So these two equations are the quadratic equation, okay, and also given a point, b point. So they are the ends of the diameters of a circle. Now we have to find the equation of the circle, okay, having the ends of the diameter are a comma b. And one more condition will be given here. Here the ordinates, ordinate means y coordinates, and abscissa means x coordinate. That means x coordinates and y coordinates. X coordinates and y coordinates are roots of the first equation, and they are the roots of the second equation. Okay, so simply here two quadratic equation will be given, and now we are going to find the equation of a circle whose points AB are the ends of the diameter, and also the coordinates, that means x coordinates of these points are the roots of equation 1 and y coordinates are the roots of equation 2. Then the equation of the circle will obtained by simply adding these two equations. While you are going to add these two equations, the second equation can be equation in variable y. If you taken this x square plus 2ax minus b square plus, you can change the variable here, y square plus 2py, sorry, here x, you can write 2py minus q square is equal to 0. Observe that you get an equation, it will be coincide with this equation, okay. This is the shortcut method to find the equation of a circle, okay, when the two points are the ends of the diameter of the circle and whose abscissa and ordinates are the roots of the given two equation, okay. You can obtain by adding these two equations, you will get the equation of the circle. This is about the concept of about this problem, okay. Now we are going to discuss about the power of a point and position of a point, okay. Now we are going to discuss about the position of a point with respect to the circle, okay. Consider here, so I am going to taking a circle here. Suppose this is the circle. So this is the circle I have taken here. Okay, now what we have to find here? The position of a point with respect to the circle. Okay, position of a point with respect to the circle. Consider the circle name is S is equal to 0. This is the circle. Now I am going to take one more point here. Let the point is P here. Okay, where you have taken this point? So this point can be taken the outside of the circle, okay. Now if you taken a point Q, where it lies? This is a point on the circle. Suppose if you taken a point here S, for example some A point, okay. If you taken this is as a point, where this point lies? This is the inside of the circle, okay. Look at here, the part of this one, this one is called the inside of the circle. Okay, next one, the part of this one. Okay, this one can be taken as the point on the circle. This is the on the circle part. Next one, this one, this part, this total part is called the outside of the circle. Okay, that means a circle divides a plane into three parts. Okay, the first part is external side of the circle. This is all exterior, exterior side or exterior of circle, simply exterior of the circle. Next one, this one here, this is called the interior, interior of the circle. Next one, the part which lie on the circle. So this part is called the on the circle. Okay, that means a circle divides a plane into three parts. The parts are exterior of circle, interior of circle. Next one, what is that? On the circle. Okay. Okay, I have taken a circle here. That this is the circle. I am going to take this circle name is S is equal to 0. Now, we are discussing about the parts of the circle in a plane. So, the first part. Suppose when you have taken a circle, you should take the center here, let it be center C. Next one, I am going to take here the part which is in the green color part, that is the interior of the circle. Next, what is the part which is you have seen in black color, that is the exterior of the circle. Okay, suppose I am going to take this one here. Okay, look at here. This is the interior of the circle. Interior of the circle. Next, this one is the exterior of the circle. This total. Exterior of the circle. Next, the point which I have taken. So, this one. This is called the on the circle. Circle. Okay, they are the three parts of the circle when the circle will be taken in the blackboard. Okay, so that is, so here now we have to discuss about the position of a point. What is that position of a point? Suppose let us take a point P here, P. Okay, now we have to check whether this point lie outside or inside on the circle. Okay, so how to check this one? Okay, suppose find the distance from center to P. What is the distance? CP. Next one, if you find the radius, so here the radius will be taken here like that. This is the radius, so this is the R. Okay, so that means observe that in the diagram here, which one is greater than, greater of CP and R? Here, look at here, the distance CP is greater than the radius. So, this is greater than the R. CP is greater than R. Okay, this is the first one. So, look at here, where you have taken here point, where P is exterior of the circle, exterior of the circle. Suppose if you taken a point, suppose this is the point P. If you taken a point P, where you have taken? On the circle. On the circle. If you taken a point on the circle, then what do you notice that? Find the distance of center to that point. This is. So, that is CP. Next, what is the radius? This will becomes also radius is equal to R here. This is the second one. If you taken a point P here inside the circle P, then what do you notice here? And also find the distance from the point to center, you will get CP. What about the arc? So radius means this is. Radius means the distance of center to any point on the circle. So here radius is more than the CP here. So here CP is less than the arc. So you will get here three conditions here. What are the three conditions? CP is greater than R. This is first condition. Next, CP is equal to R. This is second one. CP is less than R. This is the third. This condition will be applied. P is interior of the circle. So these three properties are called the position of a point with respect to the circle. We have to compare a point by taking a circle. So comparison means whether it is inside, outside or on the circle. That is the position of the point with respect to the circle. Here observe that in this one CP is equal to R. So this is will be given here. Suppose bring out this one CP square. If you squaring on both sides, you will get CP square minus R square. Now here CP minus R square, CP square minus R square is equal to 0. Here on the right hand side, what will be given here? Left hand side, CP square minus R square. Okay, CP square minus R square. This can be, if you find by taking a point P as x1 comma y1 and C is the center of the circle in general form, by taking minus g comma minus f, already we know that radius of the circle in general form g square plus f square minus c. If you substitute this one CP square minus r square, you will get an equation which is x1 square plus y1 square plus 2gx1 plus 2fy1 plus c is equal to plus c. Okay, so note here, the value of CP square minus R square is equal to the X square plus Y square plus 2GX plus 2FI plus C. Okay, in this one, now these properties are becomes to here CP minus R, the first condition, what will be there here? CP minus R is greater than 0. Here CP, this one, second condition becomes to CP minus R is equal to 0. This third condition becomes to CP minus R is less than 0. If you're taking squaring on both sides here, CP square minus R square, CP square minus R square is greater than 0. And here CP, so if you're squaring here, you will get this one, CP square minus R square is equal to 0, CP square minus R square is less than 0. Now simply we can write CP square minus R square is equal to the value, this one. So this can be simply considered as S11. Note here, the equation of a circle in general form, what is that? X square plus Y square plus 2GX plus 2FY plus C is equal to 0. This is the equation of a circle in general form. We know that this is the equation of a circle in general form. We know that this can be considered as S. So the given point P, some x1 comma y1 is a given point. If you substitute this point in this equation, you will get, what is that? X square plus y square plus 2gx plus 2fy plus c is equal to 0. This can be converted into x1 square plus y1 square plus 2gx1 plus 2fy1 plus c. This can be simply taken as S11. The notations S and S11, you have to remember carefully. S means general form of the circle. S11, here suffix you have to write 11. That means you can put directly the point, given point in this equation. That is the reason of S11. Okay, now let's take the point x1 comma y1 be a point. And let us take the circle here. This is the circle. S is equal to 0. Let S is equal to 0. be a circle. Position of a point means whether the given point is lie outside or inside or on the side of on the circle. We have to decide the given point is lies on the circle or exterior of the circle or interior of the circle. Look at here. Here yellowish part is called the interior of the circle, which containing the center also. This part is interior of the circle. Interior. So this is exterior. So orange color part is called exterior. Next, the circumference. So this one, this part, this curved part is called the on the circle. Okay. So that means a circle divides a plane into three parts, which is interior, exterior, and on the circle. So now we have to decide the given point, interior or exterior or on the circle. We have to check the condition here. That is, if first one, if S11, we have to find the S11. You get answer 0, then the circle, the point lie on the circle. Lie on the circle. Next one, if S11 is negative answer, that means less than 0, that is we have to write negative, then the point is interior of the circle. Next condition, if S11 is greater than 0, that means positive answer. S11 is greater than 0, that is positive, then we say that the point is exterior of the circle. So note that here the most important one is where S11, what is the meaning of S11? This is equal to Cp square minus R square. So here Cp square minus R square becomes to x1 square plus y1 square plus 2gx1 plus 2fy1 plus c. So this is the value of S11. Okay. So to find the position of the circle, position of a point with respect to the circle, you need to find the value of Cp square minus R square. So if you find Cp square minus R square by taking a point P x1 y1 and center C, where R is the radius of the circle in general form, you will get this equation. What is that? This one. You will get the value x1 square plus y1 square plus 2gx plus 2fy1 plus c. So this will be considered as S11. So simply to find the position of the points, it is enough to find the value of S11. So by obtaining the value of S11, if you get answer 0, the point lie on the circle. If you get negative answer, the point lie interior of the circle. If you get positive answer, the point lie exterior of the circle. This is about the position of the circle. Let's start the problems on this model. Okay, let us see the given problem here. Find the position of the point 4, 2 with respect to the circle given here. Okay. First, you have to take the given circle as S. Let the given circle is S, 2x square plus 2y square minus 5x minus 4y minus 3. This is the given circle. Next, let the given point. Given point is P, 4, 2. So what we have to find? Position of the point. For finding the position, you have to consider S11. Okay. So that means S11 means you have to write x1, y1 in the given circle equation. You get this one. So finally, by taking x1, 4, y1, 2 and substitute in this one, 2 into 4 square plus 2 into 2 square minus 5 into 4 minus 4 into 2 minus 3. So finally 2 into 16 plus 2 into 2 square 4 minus 4 into 5 20, 4 into 2 8 minus 3. That is 32 plus 8 minus 20 minus 8 minus 3. So finally adding the positive terms and adding the negative terms, we will get 31. So finally the answer is 9. Therefore you should write position of a point. What you will get here? Therefore S11 is equal to 9, which is positive answer. Positive answer means greater than 0. Therefore the point you have to write here, position. Position means where the point lies with respect to the circle, that can be you have to return. Okay. The point P lie exterior of the circle S is equal to 0. This is the problem. Okay. Let's go another problem. Okay, let us take the given problem here. So here given circle can be taken as S. X square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y minus 12 is equal to 0. Let given point P 3 4. So for finding the position you have to find S11. So first you have to write S11 means by taking x1 y1 you have to substitute in the given equation. So now put x1 is equal to 3, y1 is equal to 4 in this one. You will get 3 square plus 4 square minus 4 into 3 minus 6 into 4 minus 12. So finally 9 plus 16 minus 12 minus 24 minus 12. So that is equal to, adding positive values and adding negative values, minus 48. You will get here answer minus 23. So therefore you got here S11 is equal to minus value which is less than 0. Therefore you have to write the point P lie interior of the circle S is equal to 0. Okay, this is the problem. I have to give some more problems on this model. Okay, practice them and write the answers in the comment box. Okay, they are the given homework sums. Okay, practice them. Okay, now we will go to discuss about the power of a point. Okay, let's take here power of a point. So suppose first we have to take a point P x1 comma y1 and S is equal to 0 is a circle. Then the value CP square minus R square, where C is the center and R is the radius. Okay, if you find CP square minus R square is called the power of a point P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0. So that is already we know that. Here you have to remember that note point. CP square minus R square can be taken as S11. Already this is the value of CP square minus R square. I had discussed it in above problem. So now therefore the power of a point P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is the answer S11. Okay, To find the power of a point with respect to the circle S, you should write the formula is S11. Already we know that how to find the S11. Okay, let's start the problems on this one. Here simply power means the attracted of a point from the center of the circle. That is the simple concept of the power of a point. Attraction power. Attraction power by the center of the circle to a given point. That is called the power of a point. Okay. Let's see the given problem here. This is the very, very important problem for the 2 marks question of Board of Intermediate of Education of Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. So first read the given sum. Here you have seen a point and a circle here. Here what we have to find out here? Power of a point. So let us take the first equation of the circle is let S is equal to x square plus y square minus 6x plus 4y minus 12. Okay, this can be taken as S. Next given point. Given point is P, that is minus 1 comma 1. This is the given point. Now what we have to find? Power of a point. Therefore the formula for power of a point, the power of a point P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is the formula S11. That is equal to, you have to write S11 means directly you can substitute x1 y1 in this one. Now x1 square plus y1 square minus 6x1 plus 4y1 minus 12. So this is S11. Now you have to take this is x1 and this is y1 and put in this equation, you will get this is 6 into minus 1 plus 4 into 1 minus 12. Now 1 plus 1 minus into minus plus 6 into 1 6 plus 4 into 1 4 next minus 12. Now adding the positive values here, 1 plus 1 2, 2 plus 6 8, 8 plus 4 12 minus 12, which is equal to 0. Therefore you get the answer 0. This is the power of a point. Therefore power of a point P with respect to S is equal to 0 is the answer 0. Okay, simply the power means you should find S11. So the answer you will get is the power of the point. Let's see another problem. So here given one point and one circle, what we have to find out here? The power of a point. So let us take the given problem as S. The circle can be taken as S. Let S is equal to x square plus y square plus 8x plus 12y plus 15 is equal to 0. Next given point can be taken as P, 5 minus 6. Now the power of a point P with respect to circle S is equal to 0 is the formula S11, which is equal to S11 means x1 square plus y1 square plus 8x1 plus 12y1 plus 15. That means x1 y1 point will be substituted in this one, you will get the S11. So now you can write x1 is equal to 5, y1 is equal to minus 6, 5 square minus 6 square plus 8 into 5 plus 12 into minus 6 plus 15. Now simplifying, 25 plus 36, 8 5s are 40, minus 12 6 are 72 plus 15. Now adding here all positive terms, so here you will get 116 minus 72. Now finally you can get 44 is the answer. Therefore you should write here the power of a point P with respect to the circle S is equal to 0 is how much you will get? 44. This is the power of a point with respect to the circle. okay, they are the problems on the position of a point and power of a point. Okay, I have to give you some more problems on the power of a point with respect to the circle. Okay, practice them and write your answer on the comment box. Okay, I will look on this problem. They are the homework sums. Okay, practice them.